drive there, if you enjoy it, then do it, you know. I like to better myself, you know. I don't have any competitions with anyone else. I just like to try new styles and, you know, different techniques and stuff like that, really.
Yeah, yeah. And yo, Black, it's time.
Word,
it's timing. It's time, man.
Alright, begin.
Yeah, straight out the fucking dungeons of rap, where fake niggas don't make it back. I don't know how to start this shit. No. Rappers are monkey flipping with the funky rhythm. I be kicking, musician, inflicting composition of pain. I'm like Scarface sniffing cocaine, holding an M16. See, with the pen, I'm extreme. Now, bullet holes left in my peepholes. I'm suited up with street clothes. Hand me a 9 and out, defeat foes. Y'all know my steelo, with or without the airplay. I keep some E and J, sitting bent up in the stairway. Or either on the corner, betting grants with the CeeLo champs. Laughing at bass heads, trying to sell some broken amps. G-packs get off quick forever, niggas talk shit. Reminiscing about the last time the task force flipped. Niggas be running through the block, shooting. Time to start the revolution, catch a body head for Houston. Once they caught us off guard, the MAC-10 was in the grass. And I ran like a cheetah with thoughts of an assassin. Pick the Mac up, told brothers back up, the Mac spit. Lead was hitting niggas, one ran, I made a backflip. Heard a few chicks scream, my arm shook, couldn't look. Gave another squeeze, heard it click, yo, my shit is stuck. Tried to cock it, it wouldn't shoot, now I'm in danger. Finally pulled it back and saw three bullets caught up in the chamber. So now I'm jetting to the building lobby, and it was full of children, probably couldn't see as high as I be. It's
like the game ain't. I've always been interested in drawing. I've always sketched and drawn cartoons from when I can remember being a child. And I think when I was 18 or so, that's when I first started doing graffiti, well, street art, messing about with stencils and things like that. And then when I went to university, after university, I worked as a t-shirt illustrator, designing t-shirt graphics and stuff. I used to go and spray just little characters and stuff around like Newcastle and Middlesbrough, and then from that it's kind of led on to doing more kind of murals and commission work, shop shutters, that sort of thing.
I'm a gangster, drinking Moet's, holding texts, making sure the cash came correct. Then I stepped, investments and stock, sewing up the box to sell rocks. Winning gunfights with mega cops, but just a nigga walking with his finger on the trigger. Make enough figures until my pockets get bigger. I ain't the type of brother made for you to start testing. Give me a Smith and Wesson, I have niggas undressing. Thinking of cash flow, Buddha and shelter. Whenever frustrated, I'm a hijack Delta. And the PJs, my blend tape plays, bullets are strays. Young bitches is braids, each block is like a maze full of black rats trapped. Plus the album is packed, from what I hear in all the stories. When my peoples come back black, I'm living where the nights is jet black. The fiends fight to get crack, I just max. I dream I could sit back and lamp like Capone. With drug strips on, all the legal luxury life. Rings flooded with stones, homes. I got so many rhymes, I don't think I'm too sane. Life is parallel to hell, but I must maintain it be prosperous, though we live dangerous. Cops could just...
The name Aylo is Hayley Louise, just kind of shortened, and it's what a few of my mates called me when I was at university and stuff, so it's kind of just stuck over the years.
It's a vitamin, hell without a capsule. The smooth criminal on beat breaks. Never put me in your box if your shit eats tape. The city never sleeps, full of villains and creeps. That's where I learned to do my hustle. Had to scuffle with freaks. I'm an addict for sneakers, 20s.
To be honest, when we're out painting, quite a lot of the reactions are positive. I mean, from the most unlikely people, the people you'd expect to have a problem with it, like the older generations. They're the ones that kind of like it the most. I guess it's all just preconceived ideas that people think that it's crap and horrible and they hate it, and it's something that should be like completely illegal. But when you actually speak to people individually, then they don't see it as a bad thing. I think if you take graffiti off the streets, like if you made it legal, it'd lose a lot of its appeal to the people that do it. There wouldn't be such an underground scene, there wouldn't be artists kind of pushing out the boundaries and stuff, it just become really commercial like everything else is these days, you know. I think if you choose to make it your trade and make money out of it, fair dues. But I don't think you should really beat down anyone that doesn't. Because I don't generally do that much illegal stuff, I prefer to spend my time on a piece. And that's the part I enjoy. I enjoy the process of painting rather than the searching out spots and trying to get up for the credit of my peers type thing. I'd rather just do it for me, you know. I like to go painting because I like painting, not because it's going to impress any of my mates. So it's more rather than the feeling of going out painting, it's when I'm painting that's the part I enjoy. We're painting for a project called Outhouse, which is an ongoing project, and every 3 months this block of walls gets repainted by various artists from up and down the country.
Say sticks and stones, they might break your bones, but the 9mm, it will bore your dome. I'm talking about the toe tagging, the body bagging, man, niggas are dying, mamas are crying, casket buying, who me dying, leave my family crying. Hell no, I cause them bloodbaths and showers, send me commissary, mother, fuck them flowers. Thoughts of slaughter, I'm leaving my daughters. Hours and hours of fears running through my mind as I pick up the Zig 9 beat. Starts with the shove, then ends with the shovel. A nigga standing on your corner reminiscing of you, but your ass is out and you're dead and gone. So who'd you rather be, the murdered or the murderer? Niggas got me stressed, I got my tech and my vest, then I sing, who Jah bless, let no man curse. But one of us will leave here tonight in a hearse, when we'll be tried by 12 and fertilizing daisies, crying mamas and cousins and crying babies, due to the fact that death is a must. Ashes to ashes and dust to dust. Niggas getting bust for in God with trust. So if you're coming to my town and try to slow the dough down, you must be casket bound. Cause I'd rather be tried by 12 than carried by 6. Nigga, I saw my name in the book at your funeral. The zigs on my hip with an extra clip. Cause I'd rather be tried by 12 than carried by 6. 6. La-di-da-di. Saturday night and we like to party. But punks are fucking around so we might catch a body. Early Sunday morning don't really wanna hurt nobody. See what they trying to get? I already got it. Jump motherfuckers just to scheming on my shit. But look, doo-doo, they know I got the zig on my hip with an extra clip. And I'd rather be tried by 12 than carried by 6. Aw, shit. Murder commit. And there goes another statistic running through ballistic. The witness say I'm wicked, but that's how I kick it. Cause I'll be the bastard who blast and didn't get blasted. Boy, kiss some casket, I put your wig back, kid. Now, sucker, look who died. Body will be identified. Mama and papa will cry. A bitch ass man says he'll testify to see me try. But his ass lied upon the same corner where you did. And I'm still facing the bit, cause I'd rather be tried by 12 than carried by 6. Nigga, I saw my name in the book at your funeral. The zigs on my hip with an extra clip, cause I'd rather be tried by 12 than carried by 6. 6. 6. I told my man Phil of Phoenix, rest in peace. I told my nigga Sha Kim, rest in peace. I told my man DeLeon, rest in peace.
Like I said, I've always been interested in art and stuff like that, and I think it is like the colours that attract me to the graffiti kind of style and culture. But at school I was never very academic. I like excelled at everything that was creative and like PE and art and design and all those things. I did alright in maths and English. It was atrocious, so I just stuck to what I knew really, and I think it's just kind of gone on from there. My parents, do they think there's anything wrong with it? They're not too bothered. They've always known me to be quite creative, and I've never landed myself in any bother with the police or anything like that. So as far as they're concerned, it's a way I make a living, it's an art, you know, it's be honest, I think they're quite proud that I've actually got off my backside and done something with my life. All sorts, anything from, I mean, we've done kids' bedrooms to TV sets and canvases to floors, bars, shutters, anything really.
Have you worked with like any large companies?
I've worked with companies like HTC, we've done some work for Hollyoaks, Doc Martens, there's probably more but I can't remember. There's always like new products coming out and stuff that's improving the quality of the, like how long it lasts and all stuff like that. There's all, I mean, like the cans back 10 years ago, you could barely get a cap for them, and now you can, there's like 50, 60 different types of caps, 3 or 4 different types of paint. I get more pissed off when people don't like it. Like, it's like that guy that pulled us up day and demanded that we should have a reason for doing it. Well, our reason is that we don't need a reason, do you know? The reason is that you're just expressing how you feel. It's not a reason for anyone else. Eyes were stuck together with spray paint and like black bogies and all sorts. But then there's like pieces like just painting with mates, you know, mates that are going away, like that I'll probably not see again. And they come and like go and you go out and you paint and you do a piece, and it doesn't even need to be good, it's just the fact that you've had that moment. Painting for friends that are like have passed away and stuff like that, you know. All sorts of reasons why I'm painting today for you, man. Came up to me and was like, that ice lolly's not yours. I was like, yeah, it is. no, there's a guy on Facebook I've seen draw at Aylo. I'm like, yeah, I'm Aylo. And he's like, no, it's definitely a guy. I was like, what the fuck? No, it's not. I was like, I'm Aylo. And he was like, all right, yeah. And then just got off. I thought, yeah, whatever.
Stop.
No way.
Never stop.
No.